Thank you, Jesus. I greet you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. My name is G.A. David from Canada. I am here again, bringing to you the Word of God to sensitize you, to elevate you, to motivate you, to elevate you spiritually. Hallelujah. With my research in this world, I discovered that there is three categories of people. First category, they don't mind to go to any length to assist others. Either they have enough or not. Either they are still struggle or not, they can assist others even to hurt themselves. They can assist others even to inconvenience themselves. And the second category of people, they are really willing to help. They have it in mind to assist others, but they believe it in their mind that or in their heart that until they have enough before they could assist others. And the last category of people are the people that are not really, they are not ready to assist others. Either they have enough or not. Either they have or not. Either they have dying or not. They are not ready to assist others. But in this life, there are many, when we are talking of love, when we are talking of blessings, when we are talking of a greater blessing, or we are talking of moving forward, it's all about giving. It is all about giving. I learned something in this country, Canada. Whenever anyone love to assist others, and people don't know that is sacrifice. That is why the country is moving forward. That is why the country is really going on better. That is why, even as they are not so fervent, as they are not so prayerful, as they don't go to church even stronger, more like other nations, yet God is still blessing them. You know, I could remember there was a day I was coming from a certain place. I never went out with my car. I went out with bus. You know. A kind of destitute, you know, a less privileged person wanted to enter a bus. You can't believe it. It's everywhere in Canada. A driver will have to park. He wouldn't mind. They don't want to care about the able people. They don't want to care about you that are able. They don't want to care of any able people. They care much for them, like destitute, like less privileged people. The driver had to park, and it took his time to assist the less privileged person that wanted to enter a bus. He spent more than 10 minutes on him by bringing him in, by tying him, you know, giving him seat in the bus, all that kind of things, giving him seat belt in the bus. Those are the kind of things that we are talking about. You know, like, you know, it has been their customs. It has been the part and parcel of their lives. It has been the how do I put it? They have used to it. That's why when anyone, you know, when anyone is in need, they are ready to assist. They assist people, they assist less privileged people, they assist destitute. That is a sacrifice. People don't know. It's a sacrifice. You know, that's why the country is moving forward. Now, I'm talking about, I'm still on the track of giving. I'm still on the track of giving. Like, we have three categories of people. What category are you? What category are you? Are you ready to assist others? You know, how if you have your phone for 3 days, how many people will miss you? If you have your phone, or if you just keep yourself in a certain place for like 2 weeks, how many people will miss you? How many people will say, oh, we miss this person? How many people are you assisting? How many people have you ever assisted? Don't wait until you have enough. It is more blessed to give than to receive. If you give, it's a secret of blessing. People don't know. When you give, you'll be blessed. But people don't know. They want to keep whatsoever they have. Fine, if you keep it, trust me, it will be very hard to increase. How many people have you assisted? How many people are you assisting right now? Have you ever decided to be putting maybe just a dime or any amount into somebody's life? That, okay, this person is not able, or this person could not send his children or his people to school. Okay, this family could not send their children to school. Okay, not, you know, no matter how capable I am, I'm going to be contributing to their lives. I'm going to be supporting one of the children's education. Have you ever done that? Have you ever thought that? Have you once think of that? Are you doing that right away, right now? Have you ever done that, or are you doing it? Or you don't even have any passion to do that? Or you are thinking until you have enough before you do it? Don't wait. Don't wait. Let's quickly go to our proof text for today. The book of St. Luke. St. Luke chapter 6. Luke 6:38. Hallelujah. Luke 6:38. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. That's what I'm talking about. If you give, it's a secret of blessing. It's a secret of blessing. If you give, you will receive bountifully from God. Do you know? Let me give you this is an eyes opener. If you have the passion to be giving people, to be assisting people, God cannot afford to lose you. God cannot afford to lose you. God will protect you the more, because how many people are willing to do so? How many people are willing to help? How many people are willing to assist? And if you have that kind of passion, or if you take it as your ministry, trust me, you have more protection, because God will protect you the more. God cannot afford to lose you. Though there might be kind of challenges, but you will definitely, you know, God will definitely be fighting for you and granting you victory, even over enemy of your souls. Now, I'm telling you this today. It is more blessed to give than to receive. I used to tell my boys, any of my relatives, don't have passion of taking from people. Have passion of giving, because it's more blessed to give than to receive. Are you really having that kind of passion? Give and you'll be blessed. Give and you'll be protected. What is the measure of your giving? That's our today's title. That's our today's message. What is the measure of your giving? What is the measure? Have you been doing it, or you are planning until you have enough before you can be doing that? Or you don't even have that passion at all? Please try your best. Try your best. Test it. It's a secret of blessing. It's a secret of blessing. And God will protect you the more. If you do that, God will protect you the more. Because God can never, God will never, you know, God will not afford to lose somebody like you. Because how many people are willing to do so? Please try, sit down, see what you can do to assist others. Don't wait until you have enough. Don't wait until you have trillion, billion. No matter how little you have, use it to assist others. Trust me, you'll be blessed. Trust me, you'll be elevated. Trust me, you'll be protected the more. Hallelujah. What is the measure of your giving now? What is the measure of your giving? Change your character. Change your passion. See what God wants to use it for. See how you want to do it. Don't wait. Don't look at someone who is in need. Jesus said, when I was naked, you gave me clothing. When I was hungry, you gave me food. When I was in prison, you visited me. Disciple says, his follower says, they said, where was you? We never knew when you was naked, when you was hungry, when you was in prison. He said, if you have done it to your neighbors, if you have done it to less privileged people, if you have done it to people who are in need, you have done it for me. You have done it to me. If you have done it to those people, you are showing the love that God, Jesus Christ, transferred to us. You are showing, because if you claim you love God, you do not love your neighbors. There are many people that have enough, even more than enough. People will be there and they will have many people that are in need, but it will be very difficult for them to do. I pray by the power and the authority of God, if there is anything that is breaking, that is giving you blockage to assist others, that is not motivating you to assist others, I break that thing by the power and the authority of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Give and you'll be blessed. Give and you'll be protected. Check your measure of giving today and amend your way. I pray Holy Spirit will control your life, will put you to and will guide you to know what to do at the right time in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen, amen, and amen. I am feeling need to pray. I can feel that right now to pray. I pray as you are hearing me, watching me, whatsoever area that you are not making it right, that is causing setback, hardship, tribulation, failure for you, those area, by the power and the authority of Jesus Christ, God Almighty Himself will control it and amend that way and smooth that path in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is well in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, and amen. My name is G.A. David from Canada, and I believe by the special grace of God, you have been blessed through this message. And as you have been blessed through this message, share this message, share this video so that other people as well can be blessed. And if you want more of this message, subscribe to our channel, YouTube channel, Regain Global TV on YouTube. And on Facebook, follow us on Facebook at GA David Ministry. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening. Thank you for following us. Thank you for listening. And we believe you have been blessed, and you will forever be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Till next week that we shall be meeting. And if our Father tarries, till next week that we shall be meeting, stay in faith and remain blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Bye for now.